is the CardioNet box. This is where the Holter monitor and everything came in. On this side, this is where the equipment was. They give you an extra set of batteries just in case the ones that you have run out. And they give you a case with a lanyard. We didn't find the need to use it, but you can if you feel like it's necessary. On the other side is a quick start guide. It just shows you where to place the electrodes on the chest, how to place the leads into the electrodes. It's a great, really brief summary of how to work the Holter. Inside, they provide a patient education guide, which is a more in-depth explanation of the Holter monitor. It kind of gives some tips, some reminders, some questions and answers. So I recommend giving this a quick read through. If you have additional questions, you can still contact this number here at the bottom, and they're very helpful. They're 24/7 support, and I've spoken to them. They're great. There's also this neon green paper that just reminds you that if you don't return all of this equipment back, they can charge you up to $14.95. Your cardiologist will most likely not take this back from you. You'll have to mail it in. So there is a bag, a return bag that is provided that you just place the entire box into any unused equipment back into here and just mail it back to them. All right, and then we have lastly this ECG electrodes. This specific Holter monitor can record for up to 30 days. So depending on how long your cardiologist recommends you wearing the Holter monitor, they give you enough electrodes for the 30-day period, and you have to change out the electrodes every 2 to 3 days to prevent skin breakdown. This is the front part of the electrodes. This metal part is where we place in the leads. Then on the back, we have a gel-like pad, and this is where the electrical activity is transmitted through, and this is just the entire sticker that's placed directly onto the skin. And I'm going to show you how to put this on and exactly how to work the Holter monitor. Okay, this is the Holter monitor. It is through CardioNet. As you can see, it's fairly large in size. It has a clip on the back to clip to the side of your pants or your jeans. And the CardioNet monitor is great because it has real-time analysis of your heart rate and heart rhythm. It automatically detects any abnormalities or pauses in your heart rate, and it wirelessly transmits the information through cellular data. And it has a symbol over here when it's transmitting the information and to check to see if there is cellular signal so that I can send over the information. Now there's a large central button over here. There's two arrows on the side that you can navigate the menu with, and this just shows that it's monitoring at the moment, and this indicates that there's 49% of the battery life left. The two numbers on the side, the first 20, it indicates that there are that many events that it can record, and it has a storage space for that, and the zero indicates that that is the number of events that it still needs to transmit over. Now, in case of an emergency, you would press the central button and a menu will pop up, and then you use arrows to choose or select the symptom that you're feeling, and it will start recording 30 to 60 seconds prior to you pressing the button. Whenever there's an event or the monitor detects an event, it will start beeping and it will send the information to CardioNet. They will get in contact with you through a cell phone. You should make sure you have your phone with you. And then if you do not pick up or you need medical attention, they will send EMS to your house. So just be aware of that. Now, here are the two leads. There is the white one and a red one. And these are the electrodes that we're going to have to place the leads on. So what I like to do is first place the leads directly onto the electrodes and then place the electrodes onto the skin. It's just easier that way. So we're just going to snap them on. Like that. And then we're just going to take the stickers off and we're going to place it onto the skin. The white one goes on the upper right hand side of the chest and the red one goes on the lower left hand side. So just be aware of the placement of these electrodes. Okay, so whenever you remove the electrodes, make sure that you do it under warm, soapy water because these are pretty sticky and they can hurt when they're being removed. And remember to remove all of the leads before submerging your child in the water. As you can see, I have the electrodes already placed with the leads on. This is the red one and the white one's up here. And so whenever you remove the electrodes, they leave sometimes a sticky residue behind that's hard to take off with just soap and water. I've tried using a 2x2 alcohol prep pad, but I find that doesn't completely remove the residue. So what I like to use is Detachol. It's an adhesive remover. It's latex-free, and I just put it over a 2x2 gauze and wipe the area with this, and it does a really great job of removing all of the remaining residue. Use as little or as much as you'd like. Once you removed all traces of the residue, you can go back with a 2x2 alcohol prep pad to kind of get this oily residue off the skin before placing the electrodes anywhere there. I hope you liked this video, and give it a thumbs up if you did. Subscribe, like, comment below about any other videos you'd like to see, and I will do my best to get back to you, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.